What's up everyone, Howard Pinsky here with another Photoshop tip for all of you. Today I'm teaming up with graphicstock.com to show you one of Photoshop CC's newer features, libraries, which allows you to load in your stock graphics or stock images to use in any document or on any computer that you're signed in with your Adobe ID. And this even works across different applications. So let's go ahead, hop into Photoshop and take a look. All right, here I am in Photoshop with a really high quality set of shopping icons, which again I grabbed from graphicstock.com. They have a huge library of amazing graphics that you can use completely royalty free. And let's say for an example, I wanted to make sure these were available in any document that I'm creating or even any computer that I might be working on. So let me go ahead and grab this icon here. I'm gonna hold down my command or control key and just simply click on it. And traditionally in the past, what I would have to do is export this individual icon to a folder, maybe sync it with Dropbox, or do a bunch of other things to make sure it's always going to be available to me. But now that Photoshop has libraries as part of your Creative Cloud membership, I can simply click on this icon over here to the right to bring up my libraries panel. Now, if you don't see this icon, head up to the window menu and then click on libraries, which will bring up this exact same panel. Now, right now, I don't have any libraries or any assets in my library, so I'm going to click on this dropdown and create a new library, and I'm going to name this one Icons and simply press Create. And now anything that I add will be placed in the Icons library. And then to add something, it's as simple as selecting the layer, which we just did, and then clicking on this icon right down at the bottom, Add Graphic. And just like that, that graphic is now in my Icons library, ready for me to use in any document, on any computer that's signed in with my Adobe ID or even supported applications. Now, right now, Photoshop and Illustrator and those types of applications support libraries, but very soon, After Effects and the video editing applications will also support them. And this doesn't just work with single layers, this also works with groups. I'm gonna head over to this document. Again, I grabbed this from graphicstock.com. I'm gonna actually make a new library. I'm gonna name this one Banners. Press Create, and in my Layers panel, I'm gonna make sure to select a group. So in this case, I'm gonna go ahead and select the red banner, which is composed of a bunch of different layers, and I'm simply going to press, again, the Add Graphic button, and it's going to take the whole group with all the layers and add it directly to my library, and that will sync with my Creative Cloud account and be available to me in any document or any computer I might be working on. So for example, if I'm working on this graphic over here, and I wanna add something extra to it, and maybe let's say I'm on another computer at work, but I am signed in with my Adobe ID, all of my assets will be available to me. So I can simply grab this graphic, drag it right onto this document, and there it is. I can move it into place. I can double click on it to add layer styles. Let's go ahead and change the blend mode to, let's say, linear burn. I'm gonna add a bevel and emboss, set that to emboss, direction to down, increase the size a little bit, change the highlight mode to soft light to make it look like it's actually embedded, maybe increase the depth a little bit, head back into the blending options and turn down the fill quite a bit so it blends in a little bit more. You get the idea. The point is these graphics will be available to you just as they were in the original document anywhere you are. And again, it's not just limited to Photoshop. If I hop over here to Illustrator, I have the exact same libraries panel where I can simply click and look, there are the graphics that I just added just a few minutes ago. I can click on banners, grab the banner, drag it onto my document, move it into place if I want to, and continue my editing. I can even grab the direct selection tool, select this white layer in the background, and simply delete it if I don't want it there. And like I mentioned earlier, libraries are available in many of Adobe's applications, but they are coming to even more, especially with the video editing applications that are just about to be updated.
And that is how you can use libraries on Adobe Photoshop CC to load in and sync your stock graphics so you can use in any document or even any computer that you're signed in with your Adobe ID. If you guys want to sign up for a 7-day free trial at graphicstock.com, I put a link in the description down below. It's a great resource if you don't have the time or know-how to create your own designs and you're looking for royalty-free graphics. So thanks so much for watching, guys, and a big thank you to all my supporters on Patreon at patreon.com/HowardPinsky, especially my $25 patron Nick, who you can find at twitter.com/MabusGaming. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time. Take care.